In this video, we're going to use three different PLC programming languages to solve one problem. We're going to use two IEC 61131-3 languages and a higher-level language called C++. We'll use PLC Next Engineer to facilitate our coding, and we will run our programs utilizing the hardware and I/O on the PLC Next Starter Kit. The IEC 61131's five programming languages specified in the IEC 61131-3 standard are ladder diagram, instruction list, function block diagram, structured text, and sequential function chart. We are going to use ladder diagram and function block in our exercise. Ladder diagram was the first language developed for PLC programming. The simple explanation for why ladder diagram programming became so popular was that it closely resembled traditional relay logic diagrams. Electricians and engineers alike were familiar and comfortable with relay logic diagrams and easily adapted to ladder diagrams. Early ladder diagram programming involved entering typical relay type symbols onto a rung via handheld programming devices connected to a PLC. It wasn't long before computers and graphical user interfaces made this process much easier. This was all well and fine until more complex PLC hardware and I/O were developed, and programming languages needed to advance, thus spawning function block and other languages. Now, we are at a point in history where there's an overlap between the activities of IT programmers and PLC programmers. More complex functions are not easily accomplished with traditional IEC 61131-3 languages and require higher-level languages such as C++, which is a familiar language in the world of IT programmers. For example, C++ programs can be easily created to produce logged data to assist with predictive maintenance, or PDM. A program of that complexity cannot be easily created using ladder diagram. Okay, we're ready to start programming. Let's begin with our problem. We want an LED to turn on when two normally open push-button switches are operated. Our starter kit has push-button switches hardwired to the inputs of the digital input module. We'll use one of the LED indicators on the digital output module. We'll use ladder diagram programming first. Our ladder diagram has two open contacts operated by SW1 and SW2 on the PLC Next starter kit. Operating the coil output, we'll turn on LED1 on the digital output module. Operating SW1 and SW2 switches on the starter kit simultaneously will close both normally open contacts, energize the coil symbol, and cause LED1 to turn on. Okay, let's solve the problem using function block programming. Unlike ladder diagram, function block diagram, or FBD, does not resemble any relay logic diagram or electrical circuitry of any kind. Basic blocks of FBD are based on logic operators, such as AND, OR, and NOT. Thinking back to our problem, we want LED1 to turn on when two normally open push-button switches, called SW1 and SW2, are operated. The key word in that sentence is the logical operator, AND. If we express our problem in a slightly different way, we get SW1 and SW2 equal LED1. So, our FBD to solve our problem is built around an AND function block. As you may have guessed, operating SW1 and SW2 switches on the starter kit simultaneously will cause the AND function block SW1 and SW2 inputs to go true. This action will cause the AND function block LED1 output to go true, and the LED1 on the output module will turn on. So physically, there's no difference in operation between the LD program and the FB program. Of course, there are function blocks for other logical operators, such as NOT and OR. All right, let's move on to C++ programming. We used Eclipse IDE as our C++ editor. There are many other possible choices available. Because C++ is not an IEC 61131-3 language, it is not a programming choice available in PLC Next Engineer. With a few simple tools, a C++ project created in Eclipse will be imported into a PLC Next Engineer project. We have to create input and output ports in the C++ project, allowing us to connect the starter kit I/O via PLC Next Engineer. We create input ports for SW1 and SW2 and an output port for LED1. We then write the actual C++ program. The ampersand symbol is the logical operator AND in C++. So, the expression LED1 equals SW1 ampersand SW2 is almost exactly the same as the FBD expression LED1 equals SW1 and SW2. The coded C++ project is added to the library in PLC Next Engineer, and the program is added to the main task. The program takes on a much different look once inside PLC Next Engineer. Last but not least, the ports are assigned to their respective I/O devices on the starter kit. And we're ready to download and run our C++ program. We begin with starter kit SW1 and SW2 switches not operated. Therefore, SW1 and SW2 are false. LED1 will be off on the output module, and LED1 in the program is false. Operating the SW1 and SW2 switches on the starter kit simultaneously will cause the in-port SW1 and SW2 to go true. This action will cause the output LED1 to go true, which will turn on LED1 on the output module. So physically, there's no difference in operation between any of the three programs we used to solve our problem. The obvious question is, what programming language should you use? There's really no single correct answer, as there isn't one best PLC programming language. It's apparent that we wouldn't use C++ to solve the simple problem presented in this exercise, as ladder diagram or function block are easier and more appropriate. Each language has its strengths and weaknesses, and degrees of suitability for specific applications. And of course, the challenge is to choose the correct one. If you're just starting out in the world of PLC programming, you can upgrade your skill set with a free course on PLC Next from RealPars. Starting with the basics and working up to programming in ladder logic or C++, you'll have a handle on this exciting new technology when it's all said and done. Phoenix Contact even supplies an official certificate of completion after completing each pro course. Just check out the video description for more info.